What's up, YouTube? So I'm here to talk about a very important topic today. A lot of times in our relationships, and I'm talking about our work relationships, our personal relationships, relationships with your parents, relationships with your spouse, girlfriend, boyfriend, whatever the case may be. A lot of times in our relationships, we suffer because we don't do two things properly. We don't set boundaries and we don't manage our expectations. So in this video, we're going to talk about how to set boundaries and how to manage your expectations and why it's so important to do so.
I had a dream, you know, it's to succeed. That's when you was hating on me. But when I get bad, then you get more mad and then you start envying me.
All right, so when it comes to setting boundaries, you know, as you know, for those of y'all who follow my TikTok and my Instagram page, you know that I have this series going on, the gaslighting series that, you know, I'm working on right now, where I'm talking about, you know, people who are being gaslit. So essentially, gaslighting is when somebody, you know, uses, you know, verbal and emotional abuse to make you feel like you're crazy. And when you're being gaslit, you don't know if you're coming left or right. You don't know anything. You feel like you're walking the eggshells. It's a pretty bad and miserable place to be in. And one way that you can prevent this from happening and one way you can stand for yourself is to set boundaries. And I found out that people who struggle with setting boundaries in one part of their life often struggle with setting boundaries in another part of their life. So, you know, if you struggle with telling your boss, hey, I'm not comfortable with this, I'm not, you know, good at doing this task, and I don't feel respected when you ask me to do this. If you have a hard time letting your boss know that, you know, more than likely you'll have a hard time telling your parents, hey, I don't feel comfortable when you ask me to do X, Y, and Z. Or you'll have a hard time telling your boyfriend or your girlfriend, hey, I don't feel respected when you do this or that. You know, essentially it's standing up for yourself. And, you know, when you, the first time that you set boundaries is going to be very, very, very difficult. And a lot of times, the first time that you do set boundaries, you're probably gonna piss somebody off. You're gonna, you know, have a visceral reaction from the other side because they're not used to seeing you stand up for yourself, you know? So when you tell your boss, hey, you know, I'm doing the best that I can and I, you know, I don't feel comfortable doing this, they might threaten you, your job might be in jeopardy. You know, once you stand to your boyfriend, your girlfriend, and let them know that, you know, when they talk to you like this or that way, it makes you feel, you know, disrespected, or you're not comfortable when they say this about you to other people, whatever the case may be. Like, they're gonna feel like you're attacking them. That's how it's gonna be. Same thing with your parents or anybody in your life, you know. But you have to set boundaries for yourself because, look, if you don't set those boundaries, you're gonna see that. You're gonna slowly but surely start to feel miserable in those parts of your life because you're gonna feel like you're losing control. You're giving away your control, and that's how a lot of gaslighting happens. That's how a lot of emotional abuse happens, you know. And even me, you know, even though I do this and I'm a professional, you know, personally in my, you know, experience, like there have been many times that I've been going through life and sometimes things will happen and I'll be like, nah, something's not right here. Or I'll tell that, you know, I feel a certain way about something and somebody's only around me because, you know, the rules are different. Like they expect me to do a certain thing, and if I were to stand for myself, that would probably be the end of that friendship. And for me, y'all know me, I'll be like, hey, Mickey Ficky, I'm about to be out of this. I'm not gonna allow myself to be in a friendship or a relationship. And you know, I have a very good relationship with my family. I'm very fortunate that, you know, I can say that. But if like family, if I was having an issue with a family member to where it made me feel disrespected and it made me feel worse about myself, I would step away. I wouldn't like cut off that family member and sever all ties, you know, ASAP. But I would probably spend much less time with that person because, you know, once again, you only have yourself. And in order for me to do what I do on a daily basis, for me to be the positive person for people around me, I have to take care of myself. So, you know, self-care, it comes at a price. Sometimes, you know, when you do set those boundaries, be prepared for people to walk away. So I'm just telling y'all, so don't be like, oh, I watched this YouTube video and, you know, Kojo told me to set boundaries and everything would be great. No, you're gonna set boundaries you're probably gonna lose a lot of friends. Depending on the type of friendship you have with people, you're gonna have some issues. Maybe at work, you're gonna have some issues in your relationships. But at the end of the day, you're going to feel respected, and your self-esteem is going to be in place, and you're not gonna be, there's a less chance of you being a victim of emotional abuse, gaslighting, and things of that nature. And the second part, you know, of this video is managing your expectations. A lot of times, especially in relationships, like you, let's say you meet somebody and, you know, 2 months has gone by and you're starting to get frustrated. You know, it might not be that that person's an awful person, but maybe in your head, you thought that this person would do X, Y, and Z, they would do all these great things, and they might not be a bad person, but in your head, you had the expectation that they were gonna be this wonderful, fantastic person that could do everything for you. And the more you get to know them, you realize that the picture that you created for that person versus who they are is two different things, and that's gonna bring you frustration. It starts off as frustration, little by little, it goes up. Before you know it, it's full-blown resentment, you know? So being able to manage your expectations is a crucial part of improving your relationships. And once again, it doesn't go for just romantic relationships, it goes for all kinds of relationships, work, school, family. You know, you can meet anybody, anywhere, and you want to manage your expectations, because a lot of times, like, we're all living in our own heads and we see the world differently, you know? So you're looking at somebody and you're like, oh, this person's gonna come in, they're gonna, you know, be my everything, they'll take care of this and that. And they're sitting there thinking that they're doing the best that they can do. And, you know, they probably are putting in some effort, but it's not enough for you. So you need to know what you require at work. You need to know what you require with your friends in your personal relationship. And then you need to put the boundaries in place and say, hey, I'm going to go for this. And at the same time, you have to not have manage your expectations. Like, you have to expect certain things, right? Like, if you're at work, right? Let's just say you're a charge nurse, throwing out a scenario because I'm familiar with nursing, right? Let's say you're a charge nurse and you've been promoted and you're managing like 3 different units. Of course, you're gonna expect certain things to be done, sure, because the job has to get done, but you shouldn't expect your employees or everybody to go above and beyond, people to be signing up for weekend shifts, people to be helping you out. You know, like, if you expect all kinds of things without communicating it, there's a good chance that there's gonna be some resentment at the end of the day. So you have to be able to manage your expectations. And even going beyond that, we have to be able to, if you can, it'll help to do things without being dependent on the outcome. That's one thing that has really helped me out. I hope someone who's watching this video is able to benefit from that. I was actually watching a interview with Mike Tyson, who's one of the most insightful people online. So definitely, if you're not familiar with Mike Tyson, like, outside of boxing, please check out his podcast. He's very insightful, and this is all around thought leader. He's a great guy. He had a quote. He said that unless there's a chance of me being completely humiliated, embarrassed by doing something, I won't do it. Now, I thought that was pretty profound, because a lot of times we block our own blessings. You're never going to get to the place that you want to get to in life because you're too afraid to chase something that's bigger than ourselves, you know? So a lot of times when you want to step out of your comfort zone and try something that's different, you'll be like, nah, I don't want to do that because what if I fail? What if people know that I did this? What if, you know, I leave my hometown and I go to Los Angeles and I try and make it on the big screen and I fail and I move back to that small, you know, city, in, you know, rural, wherever, and then people are like, oh, this is the person who tried to make it big and they came back and then they failed. A lot of times people are worried about the opinions of other people. But if you can put yourself in a position to do things, manage your expectations, and not be dependent on the outcome, you can become a dangerous person. Because of course you're gonna fail at a lot of things, but a lot of times it just takes that one big break for you, and then you're able to do whatever you want to do for a living. Like, you might get the big break, you're doing movies, you might get the big break for your podcast or for your business. You know, so you have to give yourself a chance to succeed. But when you manage your expectations and you're not too dependent on the outcome, you can go far. So that's all I have for this video. I won't make it any longer than it needs to be. I just want y'all to know that when it comes to, you know, relationships with everybody in your life. If y'all can do those two things, or actually three, let me say three, but those main two things, if you can set the boundaries and manage your expectations, and also not be too dependent on the outcome of something, you'll be one dangerous Mickey Ficky. So that's what I want from y'all. I want y'all to do those three things, and I want y'all to improve your relationships by doing what I just said. So if you have any more questions about this, leave it in the comments. If you're not following me on Instagram or TikTok, I don't know what you're waiting for. Go follow me there. And if you're not subscribed to me on YouTube, definitely subscribe. Hit the bell so that way anytime I drop a video, you get the notifications, comes to your iPhone, and I want you to pause whatever you're doing and at least bookmark my video and come back to it because I think it's good stuff and it's what we need to talk about, especially in the middle of this pandemic, you know, mental health and relationships, all this stuff. That's what we need to talk about, and I'll be talking about this a lot more, not just on TikTok and Instagram, but also here on YouTube. So until next time, y'all take care.